All right, so before I get into it, this is a part two, which means if you haven't already, please watch part one. Anyway, now it's time to dig a little deeper. My name is Riley Harnett, and this is The Heap. Again. In the last episode, we went back as far as maybe 5.8 million years with the Australopithecus lineage. But our expected split with chimpanzees is as much as 8 million years ago. Now we've got to go back even further and see if any of the older fossils can tell us anything about our last common ancestor with chimpanzees. The next fossil on our list is Auroran tugenensis. Found in eastern Africa in the year 2000, Auroran is only known to us in the form of a partial skeleton with no skull. But you'd be surprised what we can learn from just a few bones. We've got parts of the femur, humerus, jaw with teeth, and a few finger bones. The whole thing is dated at 6.1 to 5.7 million years old, so it's slightly older than Ardipithecus cadaba, well within the expected time of that last common ancestor. But with no skull, no pelvis, and no feet, you might find yourself skeptical that we have enough to ascertain that it's got the sort of bipedalism that we're looking for. Looks like you'd be wrong. That partial femur has a number of traits that we would want to see to be reasonably assured that it was bipedal. See, the load-bearing nature of the femur differs for bipeds, and this requires a different pattern of bone distribution. Using a CT scan, a group of scientists discovered that this distribution of bone was very similar to ours. Problem is, the femur needed some reconstruction, and that may have affected the accuracy of that analysis. Nonetheless, even the people who criticized the science agreed that the features on the femur supported bipedalism. That's not the only piece of evidence in the Auroran femur, but I don't want to lose you in the fine details. Anyway, both the original authors and another independent review came to the same conclusion. Auroran appears to be at least habitually bipedal. But like most everything in this field, these two groups of scientists did disagree on one major point. The original authors saw traits in Auroran's femur and teeth that don't really appear until you get to early humans. So they argued that Auroran might be a closer ancestor to us than Australopithecines. Now we have found a lot of Australopithecines representing a good few species, and they appear to transition into humans pretty smoothly. Remember, they're all obligatory bipeds, and they share a number of skeletal similarities with humans. So it's a pretty bold claim to make. For them to be right, there would have to be an undiscovered lineage that lived alongside Australopithecines in Africa for millions of years. Not impossible, but a pretty tall order. Those independent reviewers didn't agree with this. They thought it likely that this femur could and probably did evolve into the femur of early Australopithecines. Of course, I mentioned that they also based their argument on teeth, so let's talk about that for a hot minute. Like us, Auroran has small teeth with thick enamel. You know, that hard outer coating. Ardipithecus, that main ape from part one, has small teeth but with thin enamel. And Australopithecines have thick enamel like us, but their teeth are actually larger. Here's the problem with this. Teeth seem to change a lot in the ape fossil record, so it's not uncommon for the teeth of two unrelated apes to have evolved in similar ways. This idea isn't too hard to think about through an evolutionary lens either. Different locations at different times have different sources of food. Logic follows that teeth and one's ability to chew would evolve alongside those differences. That's not all these bones tell us. Auroran had curved fingers, and there were some very thick muscles attached to its humerus, the upper arm bone. These features speak to its ability to climb, perhaps in similar ways to Ardipithecus. Now you have a pretty good understanding of this potential ancestor. Where do you think it fits in our tree? Its bipedalism is a big thing. Auroran proves that bipedalism was one of the first human-like traits to evolve, and very early in our lineage too. But is Auroran our ancestor? That's trickier. It might be. It might be an offshoot from a different ape who is. This question can only be answered with more remains. So keep your eyes peeled. It's fascinating stuff. But we're not done yet. Even older than Auroran is Sahelanthropus chidensis. Instead of a partial skeleton with no cranium, we've got a cranium with no partial skeleton. a cranium is just a skull without the jaw. Okay, so maybe there's a femur too, but I'll get back to that. It clocks in at 7 to 6 million years ago. You might notice that that's a much larger age range than what we've seen for other fossils. That's because Sahelanthropus was discovered in Central Africa. See, in Eastern Africa, we have an easier time dating the sedimentary layers that fossils are found in because of the molecular composition of the ash that covers the Earth when volcanoes erupt. The science of how this is achieved is a little beyond the scope of this channel, but if you're really into it and don't want to commit to a long conversation with a passionate geologist, just search radiometric dating on YouTube, and you can snag the basics pretty quickly. Anyway, this data doesn't exist for Sahelanthropus because it was discovered in the Sahara Desert in Chad. But the dating woes don't end there. The cranium was found in an assemblage of other mammal bones that were seemingly arranged purposefully, with a number of bones in a straight line. It's even possible that the skull was intentionally positioned to face Mecca. More specific dates of 6.8 to 7.2 million years ago were generated for Sahelanthropus. But if it was moved at some point by either geologic or human forces, these dates might not be entirely accurate. Anyway, this cranium has an interesting assortment of features that were used to argue that it's a closer relative of ours than chimpanzees. First, the teeth have thick enamel and are relatively small. I've already covered why this is a tricky piece of evidence with Auroran, so I totally encourage skepticism here. The hole in which the spinal cord enters the skull is oriented more towards the bottom than the back. This hole is also known as the foramen magnum, and literally means great hole in Latin. Fact check me, I dare you. This is important because having your spinal cord enter the skull from below creates a more efficient posture for a standing ape. Since bipedalism is one of the things we look for in these early apes, this is potential evidence of that. Here's the thing though. Features on skeletons vary from individual to individual. This foramen magnum is within the range of variation found in humans, yes. But it's also within the range of variation found in chimpanzees, who generally have this hole further back. This cranium also speaks to how the neck muscles attach to it and orient the head, and those muscles appear to function in the same way we see in apes. So this piece of evidence is also not ideal. Finally, the face of Sahelanthropus, like ours, is very flat and doesn't jut forward as much as chimpanzees or Australopithecines. But that doesn't appear to be supporting evidence at all. We should expect a more similar face to those groups, not to us. So these lines of evidence aren't the strongest, but it gets worse. Remember that maybe femur I mentioned? Well, it was discovered in the same fossil assemblage as the Sahelanthropus cranium. It's an ape femur of some sort, and it's about the size you'd expect to match. Problem is, it wasn't described in the original paper, and for 18 years, scientists have been on the edge of their seats, wondering if it's from the same individual. And if so, what sort of information it has on Sahelanthropus' potential bipedality? Well, this femur made its way to France and was found by a graduate student, who at the time recognized it as a fossil of interest. It was studied for some time and then apparently vanished. Anyway, just last year, those who studied it published a report in which they concluded that chances are it belongs to Sahelanthropus, but it doesn't appear to be the femur of a biped at all. The drama doesn't end there. There's currently an article awaiting peer review that offers another brand new analysis of the femur. I've read the preprint version, and to the contrary, they believe it to be further evidence of bipedality in Sahelanthropus. I guess it never truly vanished at all. It's imprudent to draw conclusions from a paper that's yet to be peer-reviewed, so we'll have to let science take its course before getting any closer to understanding Sahelanthropus' place in the Tree of Life with relative certainty. So there you have it. This is what we know of our earliest potential African ancestors. Getting answers from this time period isn't easy, and instead of answering questions, a lot of these fossils end up giving us more questions to ask. Nonetheless, bipedalism is one of the first human characteristics we see in the fossil record. Its evolution began a series of changes in our body that eventually led to us. The civilization building, home run hitting, Homo sapiens. Also, it's important to keep in mind that these three fossils were only described in detail recently. Auroran in 2001, Sahelanthropus in 2002, and Ardipithecus in 2009. I mean, sure, Ardipithecus was discovered in 1994, but it really wasn't well published on until 15 years later. All this in 20 years, with often very fragmentary remains. Imagine what we might find in the next 20. Maybe it'll be something much more unexpected. Maybe the last common ancestor with chimpanzees isn't from Africa at all. That's gonna have to be another episode, though. I guess the time has come. I'll let you get back to doing whatever it was you were doing before. But if you found this video insightful, shoot me a subscribe or find me on social media. I'm only getting started. Thanks for watching.